going on, bro?
Chilling, man. Grinding. I have plenty of calls today. Growing the business every day. Basically what we're up to.
Rolls.
What the fuck we do, baby boo?
Yes, sir. So we're gonna go pick up my boy Andrew today from the airport. He's flying into Orlando from Kentucky. We're gonna do a lot of business dealings. We got some plans, some appointments you gotta reach, some new spaces that we're looking at together, and ideally some new growth. So you guys will see him when I pick him up.
You got some rest?
Yeah.
Rest?
A little bit
here and there.
I'm on it.
Yeah.
What's going on, my man? How's the flight?
Not bad, man. Delayed a little bit because of the weather, but hey, we're here.
What? Nice to meet you, bro. Chris.
Come on, bro. You hungry?
Absolutely.
Got the whole booth.
Thank you. Awesome, gentlemen. I got drinks coming up for you. The shots with the wheels and the smoke on fashion.
We're definitely like the tomahawk and the chili.
Wagyu pastrami.
Here we go.
Beautiful.
Very good.
Gentlemen, enjoy your meal.
I'm gonna get a white.
This is called Fort Bend. It's Anatolian.
We're gonna use our knives poking up in there.
No, I have their alarms going off. I was just asking.
Okay. Thank you.
You don't eat the limes? You wanna order a bottle?
That's a $200,000 Ferrari. That's a $70,000 BMW. And I have a $500,000 Rolls Royce.
What's up, man? We got another video. What's happening?
What's good, my brother?
Yeah, good, dude.
How are you? What do you want to say to the camera?
I don't want to say nothing to the camera, man.
Give us a nugget. Give us a nugget.
That's us.
You ever seen Shark Tank?
Right.
None of the sharks ever use their money. Never.
No, they don't.
Money's just a tool, a little extra point that'll allow you to have more fun in your life. You know, imagine having like $700 million and still doing the ordinary things that you'd regularly do, or you could have extraordinary experiences that can propel and give you more insight, be connected with higher level individuals, and really find out the secrets of life. Because let's be honest, there are secrets to life. There's secrets to a happy life, there's secrets to a wealthy life, there's secrets to a happy relationship. And unless you figure those out through, you know, trial and error, if not, going through the shortcut of just, you know, connecting yourself with really happy and successful individuals, you won't have access to that level of information unless you really seek out for it. And that's why money is really important. A lot of people think, you know, money's not important, it won't make you happy. That's incredibly false. Like, money won't make you happy, but it has access to impact things that will make you happy. You know, if you get in a car accident or anything and you need an $80,000 surgery to fix a big old gash in your head, you know, anyone with an ordinary life or an ordinary job will never be able to afford that situation without going through an incredible amount of stress. So it's not worth it. You know, set up your life where you have plenty of passive income streams that can afford your, you know, quarterly vacations, that can afford your, you know, your daughter's soccer gear or your son's, you know, sports equipment, things that I haven't had available to me when I was growing up. And that's why I'm putting an extra emphasis on none of my future offsprings or my legacy or my lane will ever have to go through those kind of issues ever. Because the biggest gap that I find in is a gap of information. Because, you know, I could spend thousands of dollars a day on my regular business, my regular day-to-day, you know, whatever the expenses that I have. And then some people will make that in an entire month. And the real only difference is a gap of information, because we all have 24 hours in a day, but I have information that's better, that's impacting my life, that's creating impact for other people, and I'm also able to benefit off of that information that other people don't have.
Yo, why do you think there's such a big gap of information?
It's because the wealthy, the ultimate, the elite, want you to be poor. They want you to struggle. Because when you struggle, that means they have control. And when they have control of you, you know, at the end of the day, it doesn't become the end all goal of money, but it really relies on, you know, are you gonna operate in a way that's predictable to the 99%? Because in reality, the reason why the wage gap is so big isn't just because of a gap of information, is because they're holding back this information because they want you to stay in the system. They want you to be a part of the matrix. They don't want you to escape, because if you leave the matrix, who's gonna bag groceries at Publix? Who's going to valet your car? Who's going to do these smaller instinct gigs where someone will obviously be a superior and someone won't be? And you know, the wealthy and rich, you know, they thrive on being better and having ultimate experiences, because if everyone could have a six pack, then it wouldn't be cool. But if you had really nice, wealthy, or successful accolades, then it's a completely different story that not that many people can compare to. It's all about control. And until you learn what the wealthy actually do to break out of that control, you'll always be stuck in that matrix. And if you want to learn more about escaping that matrix, you're gonna have to reach out and contact me. I'd be happy to get on a call with you or somebody from my team, and we can explain and go dive in deeper on, you know, your current situation and see how we can help.
Yo, what's up, bro?
What's good, my man?
Where are we going?
We are going to the Waldorf Astoria to go see my boy Andrew. We got some big plans, touring some new commercial spaces, some warehouses, some offices, just to move and expand our team into and grow something pretty massive. But I wanted to ask you a question. Which one are we taking? Are we taking the Black Knight or the White Knight? It's a tough question.
Yeah, it is a tough question.
Which one do we do?
Let's do the range today.
All right, let's go to the range then.
Did you?
Yeah. Thank you, my man. Cheers.
Okay. Cheers. Thank
you. What did you get?
The manliest drink a man could ever order. Espresso martini. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Nah, man. Let's get the fuck out of here. You wanna go shopping?
Shopping? Where are we going?
Mall Millennia. And then like the Fashion Square Mall.
Will you believe me, don't you?
But it's pretty close. They're gonna do a quick shopping trip before hopping into another meeting at 3. So you have like 30, 40 minutes here. See what kind of damage we can do before we get out of here. Maybe we might even come back, honestly. I'd say we go do this meeting, then we come back. See what we like, find something. Maybe we'll get Andrew a new watch or something.
No, I haven't been to a mall in a really long time, to be honest with you. So
this is different. Yep.
I told Matt that.
So I get half already included with the rent? How much is, what's the square footage?
So what's this warehouse for right now? What are they storing here?
So we'd share half of it, and they're gonna fence it off in the middle with like a steel fence. So it's just gonna be fenced off. So like they won't be able to step over, we won't be able to step over on their side. But that's a cleaning business. Pretty solid space.
Yeah.
It's possible. You gotta like set up like racks.
How was it?
So, just checked out this warehouse space. It's got a loft area, which is nice, but the only downside to it is that it's shared with someone else.
Yeah, there is no ramp.
Right, okay.
Yeah, so if like we wanted to put cars inside or move something inside with a vehicle, it'd be a little tough. I'm disappointed. I had really high hopes for this one. I really wanted this to work, but it's not the most perfect scenario. It's perfect for regular businesses, but not for what we're trying to do, obviously.
Right.
Let's go get some shots. Let's go to the mall.
Come on in. Get in. Get in.
No, that's what's up next at the mall here. We're at the Millennium Mall, I think is what it is.
Mall at Millennium.
Mall at Millennium, yeah.
Me. Holy shit, that's a shot?
Yes, for you guys.
What the fuck?
It's a whole glass of water.
I know, jeez.
Facts.
One of the biggest sales tips that I've ever received in my life on how to sell something, like anything at all, whatever it is you want to do, a service, a product, whatever it is sell people on the lifestyle that it's going to create for them. Something that it's going to actually physically do for them, and then implant in their mind how they're going to achieve that, what it's going to look like.
If you want to talk about like selling people on high ticket things, you want to anchor. You want to price anchor. So if you're trying to sell somebody on like a 25K, you go in 4X, 10X. Say, hey, our normal packages is $100,000, but for you, because of what you need and what you want, it's gonna be $20,000. Because you're able to price anchor and keep that person on the $100,000 figure, they're gonna be like, oh, $100,000 out of reach, I can't afford that. But they can afford $10,000, $5,000, $15,000,
$25,000.
Yeah. So if you can price anchor somebody on like a higher price figure, you'll have way more luck, you know, closing somebody, because if you can attach yourselves to the services that they want, so it's 10 photos, 3 videos, you know, like 4 reels, 6 TikToks, that will allow you to, you know, be able to close somebody instantly because they're still attached to that higher price anchoring. And anchoring is one of the most important things that I do personally use to close people on high ticket. So I'll come up in a conversation and somebody will be like, they'll be like, what are your prices? And I'll be like, well, our highest ticket price is 100K. But depending on what you want and what you want out of life, we have $25,000, $35,000, $45,000. So now $25,000 doesn't seem as much as $100,000 because we're still offering the same level of service. Mm-hmm. So price anchoring, that will help you be able to close anybody in any kind of sales situation.
Yo, Andrew, you can leave that in there, bro. We're gonna come back.
Oh, are we?
Yeah.
Hey, I have a fucking
hot dog. I'm gonna change shirt.
What's going on, Jay? Are you good at golf or are you trash?
Man, I'm probably like in the middle, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Ah, you're trash.
A little bit of a rookie.
Some rubber bands about it too, huh? It's 3 p.m.
Cheers!
Cheers!
Cheers! Yeah, you ready to get smoked in Top Golf?
We're playing Top Golf. I was here for the food.
Oh, we are?
The food. In here.
Woo!
Yeah, that was ass too.
The Egyptian Tiger Woods.
Woo! What do you make it? Oh, you didn't make shit, bro.
Got stacking up. You're stacking up, right? So then 5 years later, right, it takes time. In the 5-year to 7-year mark, you're gonna have that NOI to where it's double. So instead of it being $1 million, now it's $2 million. That $12 million property, you're gonna go for a refinance, right?
Right.
You go for the refinance. The Navy Federal or whatever bank is gonna say, hey, your property, since it went up to $2 million, is not no longer worth $12 million, it's worth $24 million.
Right.
You take the $12 million out, you're like, oh shit, I'm about to get taxed. Nah, you're gonna get taxed.
Bro, that was trash.
Hey man, that last one went all the way to the blue.
Chill, bro.
Watch
I didn't record it. That shit didn't happen.
That's not my problem.
It didn't happen.
24/7.
It didn't happen. Bro.
Corner where I set mine. I don't know.
But it's because I believe in it. I know what it does. It changed my life. Where I came from, like, it wasn't like, it was like true. It was something I was dreaming about. It was something that I would go, and me and my boy Henry would walk around the neighborhood in the hood, and we would tell people, we would like talk to each other, and we'd be like, I can't wait to be able to do this. I can't wait to be able to do that. Now I'm living it. I went to the military to escape the hood. Thought that was gonna be a good escape. Unfortunately, I got out early. Is what it is. I went to IT because I was like, yo, technology, that's where the money at. That's where the network engineer is at. That's where the six figs at. But at the end of the day, I started this and I made more than six figs. I made 220,000 plus in 5 months. compared to making $110,000 a year, working 40 to 80 extra hours. And then on top of it, I'm able to change people's lives. I'm able to teach them the knowledge I know. I'm able to distribute this. I'm able to get on the stage and tell people, hey, you can do this same way someone did for me. And that's the thing, like, in the beginning, I wouldn't believe it. I would not believe networking events would change my life. But then I went and I started understanding, I started learning, and my grandpa said it one time, your network is your network. And a lot of people say, it's not about what you know, it's about who you know. Nah, it's not about who you know, it's about who knows you. And once you know that, game, it's as easy as, nah, that's not it, so we cut that out, bud.
All right, guys, that was it for the vlog. We checked out some new warehouses and we went to Topgolf with the team. Had an amazing, fun time. Hope you guys liked this vlog. We're trying to be as dynamic and change the method of the vlogs every so often just to see what works best for us. But if you guys loved it, let me know. If you guys learned anything new, make sure to drop it in the comments. Subscribe for next week's video. Every week we're uploading. And then go ahead and check out my socials. They'll all be down below. And I'll see you guys next time.